Yeah, hi everyone, welcome to MyMax Academy. In this video I will be teaching you the chapter pair of linear equations in two variables from 10th standard CBSE Max. So the chapter name is pair of linear equation pair of linear equations in two variables, right? Pair of linear equations in two variables. So this is chapter number 3 in 10th standard CBSE Max. Third chapter in 10th standard CBSE Max. So before we get started with this, let's try to understand what is linear equation in two variables. Then we'll come to what is pair of linear equations. What is a linear equation in two variables? So which means we should have a polynomial in two variables with degree 1. Polynomials in two variables with degree 1. So what is a polynomial? What is the degree and all? You can go through the videos of polynomials chapter. So linear equation in two variables means we will have an equation. Suppose for example 2x minus 3y equal to 6. So here if you see this equation, it's called as linear equation because the degree of this equation is 1, because x power is 1, y power is also 1, the highest power is 1. So it is a linear equation and it has two variables, x and y. So it is called as linear equations in two variables, right? Since the degree is 1, it is called as linear. You have an equal to sign, so it is called as equation, and you have two variables, x and y, right? X and y are the variables, so it is called up, it is called as linear equations in two variables. So this is an example for a linear equation in two variables. Now next, what we have is pair of linear equations. Pair means if I add one more equation to this, suppose if I have one more equation, suppose for example x minus 5y equal to 7. Now together these two is called as a pair of linear equations in two variables, because you have a pair. This is just linear equations in two variables. If I have one more linear equations in the same two variables, x and y, here variables are x and y, then you call this as a pair of linear equations in two variables. So in this, throughout this chapter, we will try to study about how to solve these equations and find the solution of a pair of linear equations in two variables, right? So now what we have is a general form of linear equations in two variables. So this is an example for linear equations in two variables. Example, you can have multiple examples. If you want, I can have another example, and next example is example 2 can be next example. Example 2 can be, another example can be 3x minus y equal to 4, x plus y equal to 2. So this is another example for pair of linear equations in two variables, right? We can have one more, suppose another example, example 3. I am giving various example for a pair of linear equations in two variables. I can have 3p minus q equal to 7, 4p plus 2q equal to 3. This is again a pair of linear equations in two variables. Here the variables are p and q. So the same variable should come in both the equations. Then together this is called as a pair of linear equations in two variables. If we just talk about only one equation, it is called as a linear equations in two variables. If you add one more equation, then it is called as a pair. A pair is formed, so we call it as a pair of linear equations in two variables. Now, next to general form of pair of linear equations in two variables. Right? So what that will be? General form is a1x, it's called as a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. Right? So this is called as the general form of pair of linear equations in two variables. Any equation in this form is called as linear equations in two variable. And if you have one more pair, then both together is called as pair of linear equations in two variables. And when we know, when we try to draw the graph for a linear equation in two variable, if I try to draw the graph for this first one, what we'll get, obviously we'll get a straight line, right? Linear equation in two variable, if you try to draw the graph for that, we'll always get a straight line. And again for this, you'll get another straight line, right? So both are linear equations and two variables. So both will give you a line, a straight line, when you draw a graph for them. Fine. So now we will go to example 1 in page number 41 in your textbook. Fine. So what is example 1? Where is this? Fine. So what is example 1? So example 1 in page number 41. So page number 41 in your textbook. Example 1. EG stands for example. Example 1. So what it says is, example 1 in page number 41 talks about, let us take the example given in section 3.1 in your textbook. Right? Akila goes to a fair with rupees 20. And wants to have a ride on the giant wheel and play hoopla. It's a game. Represent this situation algebraically and graphically. Graphically means geometrically. That will represent both the equation algebraically and graphically. So let's go and see the section 3.1, which is given in page number 38, the starting of the chapter in pair of linear equations and two variables, page number 38. If you read, it talks about Akila went to a fair in her village. She wanted to enjoy rides on the giant wheel and play hoopla. Hoopla is a game wherein you throw a ring on the items kept in the stall. In case if that ring covers that item, then you will get that item as a prize. That's the game that she plays. And she also goes on the giant wheel. She also rides on the giant wheel. So what it says is, the number of times she plays hoopla is half the number of times she had the giant wheel ride. Half the number of times, number of rides she had on the giant wheel. If each ride costs rupees 3 and a game of hoopla costs rupees 4, how would you find out the number of rides she had and how many times she played hoopla, provided she spends rupees 20, right? So anyway, in this example 1, we don't have to solve this equation, but we need to represent the given situation both algebraically and graphically. Graphically means geometrically, which means you should draw the graph, right? Algebraically means you should form an equation like this, pair of linear equations. If you form an equation like this from the given information, where Akila, she plays, she rides a giant wheel and then she plays the game, right? And she has a money of total 20 rupees she spent on both. So she has she was riding the giant wheel for some number of times, and she was playing the game Hoopla for some number of times. Obviously, she has to pay for each ride on the giant wheel, and then each time she plays the game Hoopla, right? So now what is given? Let's read that. So I'm again reading the question. So number of times she plays Hoopla is half the number of times, number of rides she had on the giant wheel. So that is one information. Second information, it says that each ride costs rupees 3, and each time she plays Hoopla, it costs rupees 4 for her. Totally she spent 20 rupees. So we need to find how many rides she had on the giant wheel and how many times she played the game Hoopla. So we will have to, so that those two we don't know. So we'll have to assume some variables for that. We'll say let the number of rides she had on the giant wheel equal to x. Now let the number of times she played the game Hoopla equal to y. Let the number of rides she had on giant wheel is x, the number of times she played the game Hoopla is y. Now what is given? It is given that number of times she played Hoopla is half the number of times she was riding the giant wheel, right? So which means number of times she played Hoopla, how many times she played Hoopla, y. Number of times she played Hoopla is equal to half the number of rides she had. Half the number of rides she had on the giant wheel. Right? So whatever was given in English, we have converted that as an equation. So y means number of times she plays Hoopla is equal to half the number of times she took the ride on the giant wheel. So this is one equation. And second information says that for each ride the cost was 3 rupees, and each time she played the game of Hoopla she has to pay 4 rupees. Totally she spent 20 rupees. So which means for one ride she spent spent 3 rupees for giant wheel. How many rides she had? X rides. So she would have spent 3 into x. How much money she would have spent for riding the giant wheel? 3 into x, because cost for one ride is 3 rupees, and she had been riding for x number of times. She had x rides. One ride cost is 3, so x rides will be 3 into x, 3x, plus cost of playing the game Hoopla one time is 4, and she played y times, so 4y. So the total cost that she has spent is 20. So this is your second equation. Generally what we try to do is we try to write this right without any fraction. So basically we can bring this to this side. So if I rewrite this equation, so y is equal to 1/2x, so this 2 will come this side, so then I will get 2y equal to x. This 2 comes this side, it will become 2 into y. 2y is equal to x. Then if I bring this 2y to this side, I will get x minus 2y equal to 0. So the 2y goes this side, it will become minus 2y. So you will have 0 equal to x minus 2y. I am writing that as x minus 2y equal to 0. So this is one equation. So whenever you try to write the equation, try to make sure that you write it without any fraction as much as possible. Try to avoid the fraction as much as possible. Now, so this is the second equation. The second equation, there is no fraction, so we can just write it as it is. So 3x plus 4y equal to 20. So now this is the representation of the given situation algebraically. This is the meaning of algebraic representation of the given situation. Given situation is Akila taking the rides in the giant wheel and she playing the game of hoopla. So we'll say, so equation above equations are the algebraic representation of algebraic representation of the given situation. So first part is done, where we have represented algebraically. Now we need to represent this situation graphically or geometrically. So for that, what we need to do is we need to draw the graph for both of these two equations. And we know if we draw the graph for a linear equation in two variables, we will get a straight line. So this will give you a straight line, and again this will also give you a straight line when you draw the graph. Now let's try to draw the graph for this first one, first equation. So what is the first equation? So x minus 2y equal to 0. Then whenever we want to draw the graph, right, so what do we, right, we will put a box and we will try to put some values of x and get some values for y, or you put some values for y and get values of x, doesn't matter. So now, and we know it's a straight line, so two point is enough. If you get this one point, this is another point, so two point is enough. But I always let's go for three points, so that way we'll be very sure that our graph is correct. So we'll go for three points, right? Two points is enough to draw a straight line, but it's better if we have three points and join the three points to make sure that we get a straight line. So now to draw the graph for this, first step is let's try to write one variable in terms of other variable, which means keep x alone this side or y alone this side, move everything to the other side. And most probably first check that we will do is check if any of the variables coefficient is 1. Any of the variables coefficient is 1, you try to keep that variable on the left side and move the remaining variable to the right side. That is the first check that we do. So here, which coefficient, which variable has a coefficient as 1? It can have either 1 or minus 1, doesn't matter. What is the coefficient of x? 1. What is the coefficient of y? Minus 2. So coefficient of x is 1, because before x, 1 is there, right? So coefficient of x is 1, coefficient of y is minus 2. So whichever has the coefficient as 1, try to keep that on the left side. So we'll keep either 1 or minus 1. Whichever has 1 or minus 1, keep that in the left side. So I will keep x here and I'll move this minus 2y here, I'll get plus 2y. So this minus 2y goes this side, it will become 0 plus 2y, which is 2y. So x is equal to 2y. Now once you get with this form, right? So one, so here you should have only x or only y. Which I will keep, x or y? You can keep either x or you can keep y, but we will generally choose a variable whose coefficient is 1 or minus 1 to be kept on the left side and move everything to the other side. If both of them don't have the coefficient as 1, then you can move anything to the other side, doesn't matter. You can move, you can keep 1 here and move the rest all to the other side. So here it is very obvious that x coefficient is 1, so we'll keep x here and move the 2y to this side to become plus 2y. Now we'll put different values for y and we'll find different values for x. So here we are going to put the value for y. So what is the equation? X is equal to 2y. Now I'm going to put, so now let's put I'm going to put y equal to 0. If I put y equal to 0, what is my x? My x is 2y, so x becomes 2 into 0. Don't write 20, just 2 into 0. 2y means 2 into y, so 2 into 0, that is 0. So x is 0. So when y is 0, I get my x as 0. Now let's put y is equal to 1. So y equal to 1 I am putting. You have to be careful. Then my x becomes 2y. X is 2y. So x is equal to 2 into 1, which is 2. So when y is 1, x becomes 2. Clear? Then the third one, the third point, put y is equal to any value we can put. You can put a y is equal to 2 or 3 or 4 or minus 1. Generally we go for 0, 1, minus 1. Then you go for 2, minus 2, like that. Right? So we'll put minus 1. So when y is minus 1, what is my x? My x is 2y. My x becomes 2 into minus 1. That is minus 2. So my x becomes minus 2 when my y is minus 1. So minus 2. Now we need to plot these points in the graph. So let's draw the graph. How do we draw the graph? So let's put this. Fine. Okay, so before we can put the x-axis and y-axis. X-axis, negative x-axis, y-axis, negative y-axis. Now before we, you know, decide the scale, like whether we have to take 1, 2, 3, 4 or 10, 20, 30 or 2, 4, 6, 8, before we decide the scale, let's try to, so we have, here we have formed 3 points. Similarly, let's try to form 3 points for second equation also, right? We'll try to find for second equation also. So I'm writing the continuation here. Fine. So the second equation is this 3x plus 4y equal to 20. So once you know the points for both, accordingly you can take the scale. So here what do? We have to first check which variable we are going to keep on the left side and which we are going to move to the other side. So for that, what you have to check? We have to check which has the coefficient as 1. What is the coefficient of x? 3. What is the coefficient of y? 4. So none of them have coefficient as 1. So you can keep anything here and move anything to the other side. So we will keep y here. Right? So we can say 4y equal to 20 minus 3x, the 3x goes this side, so y becomes 20 minus 3x by 4. So right, y in terms of x, so keep y alone here, move everything to the other side, right? So this minus 3y goes here, it will become minus 3x, sorry, 3x goes this side, it becomes 3x, then 4 will come to the denominator, right? Now let's put the box. As I told you, let's try to go for 3 points. So that way, x, y. Now we'll put some point for. So we'll put, starting with, put x is equal to 0 here. When I put x is equal to 0 here, what is my y? My y is 20 minus 3x by 4, which means y is equal to 20 minus 3 into 0, because x is 0. I'm putting here 0 by 4. I'll get y is equal to 20, 3 into 0 is 0 by 4. So I get y is equal to 20 by 4. So my y is 5. So when I put x is equal to 0, my y is 5. Right? Then let's put, as I told you, we will always try with 0, then 1, minus 1, 2, minus 2. Like that we'll go. So for straight line, we'll always take 3 points. 0, 1, minus 1. Right? So we will put now another point. Put x is equal to minus 1. If I put x, sorry, x is equal to 1. If I put x is equal to 1, what is my y? Y becomes 20 minus 3 into 1 by. So y is equal to 20 minus 3x by 4. Right? That is my y. So now my y equal to 20 minus 3 into 1 by 4. My y becomes 20 minus 3 by 4, which becomes 17 by 4. So I am getting into a fraction here. Fraction is also okay. I can put x as 1 and y becomes 17 by 4. But generally, plotting a fractional value on the graph may be little difficult, or it may not be very accurate, because you can't plot accurately where is 17 by 4. So what we can do is, we should avoid this fraction, which means we will not take x equal to 1. We'll try x equal to 2 or x equal to 3 or minus 1, some other value. So which means x is equal to 1 is not a good value. So we will ignore this. I'm just striking you to say that it's not wrong. It's not wrong. We are ignoring this because this is getting into fraction. So we will have to take another value. Another value we have to put x is equal to 2. You have to put and check. If that also becomes a fraction, then we cannot take that value. I mean, we can take that value, but plotting will be, you know, inaccurate. You can't exactly plot it. So fraction values are difficult. So when you get whole numbers like integers, so when whole numbers 0, 5, minus 1, 2 are integers, then it is okay. If you get a fractional number, then it is difficult to plot in the graph. So now when we try to put x is equal to minus 1, we will see what we get. Or we'll try to put x is equal to 2, we'll get what we get. So unless we get a whole number, we have to keep trying different values, but that will be time consuming. So for that, what you can do is, one small suggestion is, you take this, you find the value which gave you a nice number, 5. Right? When I put 0, I got 5. Nice number. No fraction here. Then what you do is, to decide the next value of x, you add this denominator. What is denominator? 4. 4 to this 0. What is 4 plus 0? Or subtract 4. Anything. You can either add the 4 or subtract 4. So, to the value which gave you a nice value for y without a fraction, to that value, you have to add the denominator. So, if you add the denominator, so what happens? So, what is 0 plus 4? Is 4. So, So, next good value will be, we'll put x is equal to 4. How did we get x is equal to 4? So, no, don't try x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3, because you will get a fractional value. X is equal to 4, if you try, you may get a nice whole number. So, now if I put x is equal to 4, how did I know it is 4? That is 0 plus this denominator. What is 4 plus 0? 4. You will always see the denominator. Now, what is that? Now, if you put x is equal to 4 here, then what do we get? My y is 20 minus 3x by 4. So, that is equal to 20 minus 3 into 4 by 4. Right? So, what do we get? We get that is equal to 12. 20 minus 12 by 4. 20 minus 12 is 8. 8 by 4 is 2. So, when my x is 4, my y becomes 2. When x is 4, my y is 2. Clear? Now, the next value we will put is, either you can put minus 4, or you can either add 4 to this. To this value, again add the denominator 4. So, you get 8. Or you can subtract also. To this 4, if you subtract 4, you get 0. You get back this. Again from 0, you can subtract 4. You will get minus 4. So, either you can put minus 4 or 8. So, we will put 8. How do I know it is 8 or minus 4? Whatever value we have put here, this latest value added to the denominator. 4 plus 4 is 8. Now, put x is equal to 8. Now, put x is equal to 8. Then what is my y? Y is equal to 20 minus 3x by 4. So, y is equal to 20 minus 3 into 8 by 4. Y is equal to 20 minus 24 by 4. And I will get y as minus 1. Y as minus 1. So, then what we do? We put, when x is 8, y is minus 1. Now, we are going to plot these two points on these points on the graph. Now, what is the highest value that x has? 8. Here 0, 2, minus 2. So, we have to put till 8. So, I will start from here. So, I will say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. I am taking scale as, scale is x-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, and y-axis, my scale is again 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Right? So, I will try to write the scale little above. Right? So, scale is x-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, and my y-axis scale is also 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, because that is enough. I am getting till 8. This is 8. So, this will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, you can put till minus 8. Then what is the highest value for y? Y is 5. So we should put at least till 5. You can put a little more than that also. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I can put till 6. So here I will have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Clear? Now we are going to plot the points. So first let's draw the graph for this equation, x is equal to 2y. 0 comma 0. 0 comma 0 is this point, origin. Then 2 comma 1. 2 is where x is 2. 2 is here and y is 1. Y is 1 here, x is 2 here. So both of them meet here. So this is point is 2 comma 1. Then minus 2 comma minus 1. Minus 2 is where, minus 2 is here and minus 1 is here. Minus 2 on the x is this. Clear? So this is minus 2, this is minus 1. So both are meeting at this point. So this is minus 2 comma minus 1, which is this point. Now join all these three. So this point and this point, join all of them. So you'll get a straight line. You'll get a straight line, and this straight line is for the equation, this equation, x is equal to 2y. You write there, x is equal to 2y is this graph. So we have drawn the graph for this. X is equal to 2y, we have drawn the graph. We have plotted three points and we joined. Then similarly, let's plot this point, 0, 5. We are going to draw the graph for this equation, 3x plus 4y equal to 20. 0, 5. So x is 0 here and y is 5 here. So this point is 0, 5. Clear? Then 4, 2. So I'm just trying to put little bigger. Right? The bigger points are what we have plotted. Then 4, 2. 4, 2 comes where this is 4 and this is 2. 4 and 2 meet somewhere here. Fine? 4, 2. This and this, they'll meet somewhere here. It'll come somewhere here. This point is 4, 2. Then 8, -1. So 8 is here and -1 is where? Down is here. This is 8, this is -1. So that will come here. Now we need to join these three points. So this is 0, 5 and this one is 4, 2. Right? And this one is 8, -1. See, in the graph sheet you will get it properly. And I'm drawing with the free hands. This is the graph. That is also a straight line. My diagram is may not look like a straight line, but if you draw, I'm drawing with a free hand. If you draw with the proper ruler and pencil and all that, and if you take proper scales and put it, you'll get a straight line like this. So it's a straight line covering all the three points. Right? It will go. Fine. So it will go, you will get a straight line. So what is the equation of this? This is 3x. So equation of this line is 3x. So this is y axis. So 3x plus 4y equal to 20. 3x plus 4y equal to 20. That is the graph of this line. So this is the graphical representation or geometrical representation of the given situation. A given situation that Akila going, taking the ride and playing hoopla and all that. So this was the two equation that we had. That was the algebraic representation of the given situation. This is the geometrical or graphical representation of the given situation. Clear? So this is how we do algebraic representation and graphical representation. Graphical means geometrical representation. So whenever you draw the graph for linear equation in two variables, you will get a straight line. One straight line for first equation, another straight line for another equation. Fine. So we'll stop here for this session. We'll continue in the, we have the next video for the continuation. Thank you.